guys, it's IDW, and today we are back looking at our CPU, and today we are going to be adding some significant things onto it that are going to allow us to pretty much be able to actually finally get some functions running, but it's still not going to be running perfectly yet. But at the same time, I'd also like to say that I've made a few tweaks to this myself. You can see one of them right here. Basically, I went through and wherever I found a piston bud, I basically fix it like this, and yeah, that's basically just how I do it. It's really simple to do, and yeah. But anyways, the other thing that I did, that you can sort of see another thing that resulted from it, is that I came around here and I basically put repeaters in this delay, this carry line right here, and that's going to make it so that it's significantly simpler for us to... Well, it's significantly simpler. It's going to make it so that it actually adds. Boy, I can speak today. But anyways, so the first thing that we're going to be doing is we're basically going to be adding on basically register selectors, because we're going to be receiving a binary piece of information from the bit layout, the value that's going to come out of memory, and we basically need to make that two-digit binary number into something that we can determine is a register. So we're going to be using decoders to do that, so yeah, I'll build that, and I'll see you guys when I'm done. So building those things may have seemed simple, but to be honest, it was most of what we're doing today. Yeah, because at this point we can pretty much already just use this ALU the way that we want it to, if I just unbud that. But anyways, so basically what we've done now is we've made it so that we can send data into the ALU. But the data coming out of the ALU is already being sent directly into the registers. So all we really need to do is just have a simple command that tells our registers to read out the value that is sent in here, and we're going to have it after a certain amount of time. That is the amount of time that it's going to take to process through this register. We're going to want to have it save that data into the registers. And that's really all that we've got left to do. And this particular signal is actually the signal that is going to be sent in, that the clock is going to actually send into the CPU. So yeah, if we were to hook up a basic clock to this after this episode, we're going to have a basic CPU that's already basically functioning. So yeah. So now let's get to work on this thing. So first of all, we're going to need to read from both of our registers at the exact same time. And everything in the ALU is already synced up, so if we just synchronize these two, that is this command back here, which tells it to basically read from that address, and this command right here, if we just take them together under the same timing, then it should just send the data into the ALU just fine. Now, getting the data into the registers is going to be another matter, but for the moment, that's all we're going to do. So, yeah. Okay, it's a very, very good thing that I tested this out before doing this on camera, because it turns out that I have just found the first bug in our CPU, and it wasn't actually a bug, really. It was just something that I thought was backwards, and yeah. Basically, I mixed up the most significant bits and least significant bits. This bit over here on the end is the least significant bit, and that bit over there is the most significant bit. And the thing was that I basically thought that when I added the repeaters in here, that the repeaters, I had them facing it so that they were facing the wrong direction. And yeah, so I also had to redo the timing down here, which wasn't a big deal. But anyways, so yeah, it's a good thing I caught that early. And yeah, so now let's just flip the lever and see what happens. And as you can see, we get our result of 8. And basically, this is inverted, so this is in fact 8, and not whatever this is, 255 minus 8. So, yeah, and it's inverted because the registers require inverted inputs, so yeah. Anyways, so with that out of the way, that's really just about everything that we can do at the moment. The next thing that we have to do is to, what's it called, hook this up into the clock. Oh, yes, one thing I might as well mention though is that you might have noticed that if we do this again, there's a slight flash on the first four bits right before this bit changes, and the reason for that is basically just the fact that we're using a ripple carry-based logic, and that's basically going to make it so that there's a bit of time before it updates. But we have to are going to have to make sure when we're getting the timing right on this guy that we're going to basically we're going to have to make sure that it's going to be after the point where the result gets finalized. So yeah. So I don't know how many of you have ever done synchronization, but for those of you who haven't, there are two basic ways that you can synchronize something. The first way is basically that you just go in and you count the amount of delay in this. And the problem with that is that there's multiple paths through an adder, and especially with one which isn't synced, it's really hard to follow all of them. So we're not going to be doing that. And the other reason is that it's really easy to lose track. The simpler version, in my opinion, is to just take a certain amount of delay and see how long it takes for that. Well, basically, we're just going to flip this lever, and we're going to see how long it takes for this to turn on. Ah, that looks like it works. So that is a total of 12, huh? Maybe I was just seeing things. Sorry about that. I don't have the best eyes right now because it's sort of late in the evening. Not too late yet, but yeah. Anyways, so it looks like our total is going to be 12. So that means that after 12 ticks, we're going to need to basically just save this. And unfortunately, we're going to have to add on an extra tick here. Actually, that doesn't matter. We just need a total of 12 ticks. 11 and 10 coming into here. So that means that at this point, yeah, so this is 10, 9, 10. And we can just take this guy up like this. Oh, I should probably come over here and write down a note that's basically just going to say the what's it called? ALU time 12 ticks. And once again, sorry, this is a bit tedious. So this was at 9 now. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, this should be working now. So we can get rid of this. That's some vigorous clicking. And now okay. So now we should basically be able to save this, and I'm going to have it save it to the very last register, which is this one right here, so we're going to be able to see it immediately. And as you can see, this piston retracted, which basically means that it saved it. So yeah, absolutely perfect. Everything is working. And if we wanted to, we could potentially just go through and use all of the functions by flipping the various levers for the like stuff that edits it, like this guy right here. We could change him. If we put a lever there, we could this the carry out. Because the carry-in is over here, we could carry in and all sorts of things. But at this point, that's everything I wanted to do today, and yeah, so I hope you guys have enjoyed and enjoy the footage of me building.